Hi, hello students, so welcome to this module number 2, the first law of thermodynamics. Here we are going to discuss about energy as a property and mode of energy and extension of first law of thermodynamics to a control volume and modes of energy. Okay, so here we will discuss how the energy is a property of system. Here we consider a system undergoing a cycle changing from state 1 to 2 by process A and returning from state to 2, 1 by process B. So these are all the things we are drawn on PV diagram and showing the different process and having different paths. Okay. So according to first law of thermodynamics, we know that the heat and work are mutually convertible. So hence we can write it as cyclic integral of dou Q is equal to cyclic integral dou W. Okay, so now we consider the process 1A, 2B, 1. So for the previous, with respect to the previous figure, so we can write it as 1A, 2, 2B, that is dou Q, plus 2B, 2, 1B, dou Q is equal to 1A, 2B, dou W, plus 2B, 2, 1B, dou W. Through the cyclic integral we consider as equation number 1. Now we'll consider another cycle, that is 1A2C1. For this process we can write 1A2A dou Q plus cyclic integral of 2C21C dou Q is equal to cyclic integral of 1A22A dou W plus cyclic integral of 2C21C dou W. That is equation number 2. So now what we have to do, equation 1 and equation 2, we have to consider and solve that. So what we get finally, that is 2C and cyclic integral of 2C1C dou Q minus cyclic integral of 2B21B dou Q is equal to cyclic integral of 2C1C dou W minus cyclic integral of 2B1B dou W. So by taking rearranging this term, we can write it as cyclic integral of 2C21C dou Q minus dou W is equals to cyclic integral of 2B1B dou Q minus dou W. See, here you can find out, you get the, after rearranging the term, you get the term dou Q minus dou W. Okay, that quantity what we called as internal energy, as you know. Okay, that is state between the 1 and 2. This value depends upon only the end state, not by the path it's followed. So therefore, dou Q minus dou W is equal to dou E, as we already told. It is a point function. So the term dou Q minus dou W, the combining the term, that is energy, that energy is property of system, not an individual energy, dou Q or dou W. So the combining the difference between dou Q minus dou W is equal to dou E, you got it now. That term is only a property of system. So if it is integrated between these two, state 1 to state 2, and we can write it as Q1 to 2 minus dou W1 to 2 is equal to E2 minus E1. See, by observing this figure, what we can write it as further. So Q1 to 2 minus W1 to 2 is equal to E2 minus E1 we wrote. So here E2 minus E1 we wrote. We are not writing E1 to 2, we are not written, because E is a property of system, so we can, and it is exact differential. So whereas Q and W are inexact differential, we can't write Q2 minus Q1. So we have to write it as Q1 to 2 and W1 to 2, like that. So hence the energy is a property of system. Okay, next. And different modes of energies are there. So if you consider a property for energy, example, for stored energy in the first law of thermodynamics, so it represents what sum of all the types of energies. Okay, and it while transferring the energy from system to surrounding, the different form of energy it represents. This may present in any form energy. It may be in any form, either it may be kinetic energy, potential energy, chemical energy, thermal energy, electric energy, so on. Okay, so however, thermodynamics is a practice to consider kinetic energy, potential energies separately and group it all types of under one category known as internal energy, that is denoted by U, and it is a combination of total energy is nothing but internal energy and kinetic energy and potential energy. So then in the absence of kinetic energy, potential energy, or we considering the very small value of this, so only hence we consider that energy is nothing but total energy. So hence we first of thermodynamics non-flow process can be written as dou Q minus dou W is equal to dou U. Okay, this is about the modes of energy. So I hope you understood the concept of different modes of energy and how we are going to derive energy is a property of system. So this is also very important. Please go through this video and practice the derivation. So you have to prove the energy is a property of system. I hope you understand. Thank you very much. We'll discuss further topic in the next slide.